Abandonment. The this was the necessary street abandonment under the IGA of Cumming and Forsyth County. The documentation, the legal documents are not ready for that to be done. So I would recommend that be postponed to the August meeting. I have a motion. A motion from Lewis to have a second. Second, Quincy, in discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay. Your motion, the agenda be approved as agreed.
I've got a request for addition to the new bills.
Okay.
And that being that the city clerk will process or audit all of the food and alcohol vendors that license in the city, make sure that they are living up to the code and that their smoking and no smoking zones are living up to the code.
Okay, I expect that with approval of the board of the new business, item D, audit all food and alcohol license venue?
Yes.
Okay, well, you made a motion that said? I got a motion, I have a second. Second round. In discussion, all in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay, that'll be item D under new business. Any other add-ons, corrections to it? Jim? Not, I hear a motion that be approved as amended. Have a second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay, item three, executive session. Council, do we need executive session?
No, sir, we do not.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, item four, consideration for adoption of regular council meeting minutes on June 18, 2013. I assume everybody got a copy of the minutes of that meeting. If no corrections, the city will entertain a motion.
Thank you, Paul.
Got a motion, I have a second.
Right.
Motion and a second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay, item five, acknowledgements, proclamation, resolution, not being, I don't think there's any.
Speed pumps on Buford Drive and Rezoning.
basically that's going to address the speed on the two roads. It will not really address the traffic. But the back traffic that does include the UI that often will reduce the speed of cars going through it. Any questions from the office staff? Alternate two is placing a island on the 499 at Ridgecrest Avenue intersection. That's the main Ridgecrest Avenue, but it light in, light out. What that will do is basically those cars that are utilizing Ridgecrest Avenue to go to Elm Street, it will force them to go north rather than across a 499 to the high school or to the middle school. Again, we'll address some of the cut-through traffic, but it's probably not going to solve the cut-through traffic.
In reference to that ride-in and ride-out only, you're looking at Highway 9 intersection, and I don't know where, I didn't see this in particular, but most traffic that leaves Ridgecrest comes south, and you're having, I'd say, 90% that comes south on that. You're having it all an island there where it would be right turn only off of Ridgecrest.
Yeah, and if you're on Highway 9 or north from the city, you can take a right, you make a right in Ridgecrest. If you're on Ridgecrest,
Right in, right out.
Yes, sir.
Now, obviously that would probably reduce the traffic a lot.
That will address it to some degree, yes, sir. I wouldn't say it'll fall completely, but it will address the problem to some degree. Okay. We'll give it to you next alternate. Alternate three. Alternate 3 is basically what you see in Alternate 2, with the exception of adding a channelized island on the Ridgecrest at Mill Street, that you cannot include in the Mill Street or Ridgecrest. What that essentially would do would include any traffic from going around Mill Street onto the Blue Farm Road. And basically, of course, the old Alternate. Probably the best solution for you to address the cut-through traffic. So, Ridgecrest Avenue essentially is a right in, right out. That's an alternate two. You're adding an island there, Ridgecrest Avenue, and Mill Street. It includes, in fact, you wanted to say you're on Ridgecrest Avenue and you wanted to go back over the mill, you're still able to do that. You wanted to go to the north, you can just go back, cut it right, and set up nine. On Mill Street, wanting to maybe go to 799, we're still going down this bridge, ride out, go right to the right across Mill Street. One thing that this does that is different from Alternate 2, again, as I said earlier, would allow people to use the Proclamations Road. This alternate here would be, in fact, Proclamations Road to the deal. Alternate 4 is essentially Alternate 3 again, with the exception of the red and right turn lane off of Elm Street and a left turn lane on 799 at the intersection of Elm Street and Ridgecrest. Again, this is in the study that we did recognize there were some accidents that were occurring at that intersection. Basically, a lot of different accidents were due to cars coming out of Elm Street. On the southbound line, which will allow revenue for those vehicles to turn and make that movement. Also, vehicles will be accidents occurring with northbound traffic for those vehicles turning left, say about 9 northbound, on to Elm Street. address that and address the concerns that we had that was addressed on the floor. Any questions in regards to that?
I know you got an additional extensive study, but you've got a lot of numbers and so forth in reference to this, and what numbers you would have in the event you implement, say, proposal three, Ridgecrest and Highway 9, where would the increased traffic be forwarded to due to the fact that the impact it would have on the traffic that would normally use that impact?
What we would find is it's going like a mountain that traffic flow from Ridgecrest, what's going to happen there, traffic is going to be there today, so kind of other routes.
Residential units, side setback on each side, or 11 foot variance from our 20 foot side setback requirement in the MU zone. The agent was made application on behalf of the property owner to rezone 51.61 acres from planned shopping center to the mobile uses with the conditions that they've attached. The property is currently vacant, and the owner is set to develop 131 unit single family detached residential component, including an amenity area and a retail component, totaling approximately 2.38 acres. After the planning board's public hearing and reviewing the revised rezoning exhibit, including the request of variances and proposed conditions, the staff recommends approval of this rezoning request and variances with changes to the applicant's proposed conditions. And I would like for the record to read the changes that the staff has recommended to the applicant's conditions. They're the last two pages in your packet on this rezoning. After reviewing the applicant's proposed rezoning conditions dated May 20th, 2013, the City of Cumming is proposing the following revisions additions. Condition number two, the second sentence shall be changed to read, the remaining portion of this property consisting of the retail portion shall have two entrances, one entrance on the Buford Dam Road, which shall be a right-in, right-out only, and one entrance on Sanders Road. This is for the corner piece, retail portion of the corner of Buford Dam, Sanders Road. Condition number six will be removed in its entirety. Condition number eight, beginning of the first sentence, shall be changed to read, exterior illumination will be provided. Condition number 11, the first sentence shall read, all commercial buildings shall be of masonry construction, i.e. hardy plank, rock, stone, cast stone, or split face modular block. Condition number 11B, the first sentence shall be changed to read, the retail portion of the property shall contain landscape islands with trees and shrubs to prevent monotonous farming areas. Condition number 11B, the first sentence is referencing new billboards in the retail portion of the development shall be removed in its entirety. The second sentence, which is now the first, shall be changed to read, no additional billboards, electronic signs or signs on poles are permitted in the development, not to exclude for sale signs, monument signs, directional or substitution signs. We have six conditions that we're proposing to be added. Condition number 25 shall read that per the City of Cumming Zoning Ordinance Section 113-80, multiple use district, residential density and residential services fee, due to the increased governmental services that are required for an AMU district, all residences therein shall pay a sum established with Section 12-101, which is $85 per month per residence, on the first day of the month after granting of certificate of occupancy or after rezoning to an MU for existing residents. Condition number 26, the amenity area shown on the Potter Marketplace rezoning exhibit shall include two standard-sized tennis courts, an 800-square-foot pool, a 2,900 square foot clubhouse for use by the residents of the residential portion of the development. Condition number 27, all parking spaces in the amenity area and the retail portion of the development shall conform to the number and size according to the City of Cumming parking regulations. Condition number 28, each residential lot shall have to be a minimum size of 58 feet wide by 110 foot deep as shown on the total lot layout, and shall have a concrete or paved driveway of at least 20 feet in width for the entire length of the driveway. Condition number 29, the developer agrees to install 4 foot wide concrete sidewalks and decorative street lamps on both sides and the interior collector streets throughout the subdivision. And condition number 30, residential lots 1 through 13 shall be screened from Buford Dam Road by an earthen berm, a minimum of 4 foot in height, planted with Leland cypress, minimum 4 foot high, planted 10 feet apart, separated by great vertical seed planted in between the Leland cypress. I'll be happy to answer any questions you might have on this, and remind you that after this afternoon, we do need to have a public hearing on this matter.
Okay, question, Scott, in condition number 11, all commercial shall be of masonry stone. This may be in some of the old, as far as residential, plus here on the residential.
That's what I was trying to, now that was in their conditions. Which it says. That's condition number 12 in the applicant's condition. It says that the, and I'll read condition number 12. Residential facades, these residential fronts located in the residential portion shall consist of a combination of brick, stone, and glass, max exemption not to exceed 40% surface area as proposed. Facade examples with decorative wood or cement material such as hardy plank. Exterior building material shall not be aluminum, standard precision block, vinyl, or aluminum siding or corrugated steel. Not to exclude metal. So they're required to use masonry products on the residential facades also.
They specifically mentioned brick and rock or anything in that really, I don't think you mentioned hard rock.
It does mention it does mention a combination of brick, stone, or glass.
And 40%?
40%.
Yes. Council, have any questions? Say we need a public hearing.
Yes, sir. We'll need a public hearing.
Thank you, Scott. I hear a motion to open for public hearing. All in favor, signify by your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Anybody here like to speak in favor of the zoning application 201-3149?
Good evening, Mayor. Members of the council, I'm Emory Lipscomb here on behalf of SP Buford Dam LLC and rezoning request number 201-3148. We are in agreement with the conditions as read by Scott Morgan. We appreciate the cooperation and suggestions that we've received from the staff. Brother Potter is here with you tonight. We're glad to answer any questions.
Thank you very much. Anyone else like to speak in favor of zoning application 201-3149, Buford Dam Road, LLC? Anyone here like to speak in opposition? The zoning request 201-3149, SP, Buford Dam Road, LLC. Hear a motion, public hearing be closed. Motion is second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Okay, Scott, recommendation of abandonment, is this be approved?
Yes, sir, that's a recommendation with the applicant's proposed conditions along with our revised conditions that I read in the record.
I will note one thing that the agenda is not the same as the number assigned to it by the department. It is actually rezoning request 201-3148. So before we take a vote, we'll just reference that number of the agenda.
So 201-3149 is 201-3148?
Yes, that's correct.
Well, that could cause an issue, I don't think. That is typographical.
It's typographical error in the agenda, and I just checked the actual application submitted originally, and it was assigned number 201-3148.
Are we sure this is right, then? 201-3148?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other thing to come forward? The board in reference to zoning request 201-3148? Okay, this is something that was postponed at the last meeting. It's been worked on for several months. This is an MU zone, mode of use zone. I would recommend to the board that we approve this as presented by the planning zoning director, Scott Moore. Chair, entertain a motion. second by Bush. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. One comment. This is a very sensitive area, and we want to be sure all environmental rules are regulated is followed and kept up to date.
Yes, sir. As we proceed the project, as the developers submit plans for it, we'll certainly look at it on a daily basis.
Thank you very much, Mr. Moore.
Thank you.
Okay, on the new business, we have item A, request to purchase a video camera for police cars. Chief Tatum.
Good evening, Mayor. Yes, this is a request to replace six of the e-car video systems that we have. The ones that we have now, the majority of them are not optimal. Either the audio or video that not working on. We budgeted for this year, and I've had a quote to replace the existing camera with the upgraded version of it, and it's for $36,310. That's six cameras in the installation, and everything to put them back there.
Okay, I see your bid here, and it's got reference to this. I think this was in our budget, 2013 budget. It seemed like it was what, $38,000, $39,000 for new radio for the car.
Yes, we actually got a trade in credit,
and this is because your current video radios are obsolete, is that correct?
Yes, we can't replace parts on the video network again. They don't have that model anymore. And also they don't meet the standard for the same. As far as record conditions, we have to maintain our videos for 5 years, and we can't do that with Francis.
Estimate here, a quote from Digital Alley, is that correct?
Digital Alley.
And it's $36,310. And there was no other company that bid on that, right?
Well, we have a back-end software package. We're going back with the same identical camera. Otherwise, we'd have to replace software and everything. So we already have the packaging components to make this work.
All right, what's the pleasure of the board? We have a recommendation here, $36,310, and it's in the budget. Motion Grant, have a second. Third point, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, Chief. Okay, item B, Park and Recreation, following another brochure request.
Thank you, Mayor. We're trying to wrap up the summer season now at the Recreation Department and Park Center, and we're getting ready for our fall and winter program. Coming to you again with bids for the cleaning of our program for sure for the fall and winter months. We have received bids for the cleaning of 25,000 copies of the 16-day brochure. We mailed out, there's 11 here. Request for bids and received two back. The two bids we received back were from the Gravitt Edge for $4,070.92. And the other bid we received back was from American Cleaning Company in Alpharetta. Their bid was $5,410. Our recommendation is that we go with a low bid from the Gravitt Edge here in time for the cleaning of the brochures. They have done quite a bit of work for us in the past and have performed very well.
Okay. We have a request for Carolyn and one brochure for the coming park and rec at $4,070.92. Graphic Aid for Cumming, the local company. And that's the recommendation of the park and rec board. So, Chairman, and motion. Motion to have a second.
Second.
Second, please. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you,
Mayor. Okay, item C. Information on This will be put in the paper. I'll read the public notice. This is for information only. The City of Cumming municipal election be held Tuesday, November 5th, 2013. Offices be in the field by those of two council members and the mayor. Any person interested in seeking the office of council and mayor must file a filing fee of $360 for the office of mayor and $180 for the office of councilman. And file a notice of candidacy in the office of city clerk between the hours of 8:30 and 4:30, beginning Monday, August 26, 2013, and concluding on Friday, August 30, 2013. To qualify as a candidate for the office of mayor of city, councilmember one must be 21 years of age, resident of the city of Cumming for the preceding year of the date of the election, qualified voter of the city. For the purpose of the elected members of the city council and the city of Cumming, two council posts currently up for election designated as post one and post two. Any candidate when qualifying for membership on the council shall designate the post for which he or she is offered. The designation will then be entered upon the ballot and the ballot labels so that the election such candidate shall only oppose the other candidate designated that post. Likewise, any candidate for mayor shall enter his or her intentions or his or her notice of candidacy and shall oppose the only other candidates designated that particular office. For each council member post and also the office of mayor and county receive the highest number of legal votes for the office qualified shall declare elected. The city charter expressly provides for throughout the road election, not majority vote election. The mayor and two council members elected November 5th, 2013 shall hold office for a term of 4 years beginning January 3rd, 2014, and until their successors are elected and qualified. That's information only on the item one under administration. Item eight, announcements. I add that the Porter Beach Grand Nationals open ceremonies will be 8:30 on July 24th, 2014. That's always a big event. This is the third time I believe we've had the Grand Nationals for that event. We look forward to hosting it again. Also, 4th of July, I'd like to thank all the people that are involved and came out to the parade, the fireworks, the cleanup crew that did an excellent job after the parade, cleaning up the streets. So, as usual, the school department done a great job. So we're going to go back to item D under the audit for all food license venue. That was an
add-on. We've never done this before, so my ESP tells me we need to do it to make sure that the food serving venues and alcohol serving are meeting the ratio prescribed in the ordinance. So I'd like to instruct the clerk, Jeff Holman, if he needs any assistance, he can get our auditors to review the records of these, and they can pick them at random and do a little auditing.
Okay, you make that formal motion.
Make that formal motion.
Okay, have a second. Motion and second that the auditing department will check the all the food and alcohol vendors that license with the city of Cumming. Let them know that they will be subject to be audited. Is that your
motion?
Yeah. Okay. Any other discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Do not stand for any effort. Any other business come for this body? If not, I hear most adjourned.
Make a motion.
Second.